Kinekis. I'm Castiel.
And I'm Naya.
Hey, it's so good to see you again, Naya.
You too. Let's jump into the lesson now.
Have a good time. Gonna be up in the air with some God time, and you're good on the genuine. Like it. Illumination, illumination. You light up my life like you lit up creation. Won't let me drown, you my flotation. Won't let me thirst, cause you my hydration. So I'ma do my dance in your arms. This love is gonna last in your arms. You're everything to me, everything I need, everything I wanna be, JC.
You got me like, yeah. Oh.
To the right, praise to the front, praise to behind, praise to the left, praise to the right, praise to the front, praise to behind, praise to the left, praise to the right, praise to the front, praise to behind, praise to the left, praise to the right, praise to the front, praise to behind, praise to the left, to the right, to the front, to behind, to the left, to the right, to the front, to behind.
Hello, Kinect kids. I have a question for you. Have you ever been in a storm? You know, one of those big, scary storms? The ones where the roof rattles and you think, oh my gosh, is it going to fly away? And the one where there's big lightning and thunder everywhere and it just seems so loud? Well, that's what happened in our story today. Our story takes place in the New Testament. And it's something that happened between Jesus and his disciples. And it's a pretty amazing story. So, Jesus had spent the day teaching everyone. And he said to his disciples, you know what? You guys go on ahead of me. I just need a moment to have a break because there's been lots of people and I've done lots of talking today. And so that's what the disciples did. The disciples hopped in their boat and off they went. And they, as they're rowing across the water, and they were doing that, all of a sudden, this storm starts to come. Now, you have to remember that lots of the disciples were fishermen. They were used to being on the water when there were little storms. But let me tell you, this wasn't a little storm. This was a big storm. And they started to get a bit worried and scared. And there were big waves crashing on them. And there was thunder and lightning. And it was a bit, oh my gosh, are we going to get through this? And then one of the disciples yelled out, "Oi, can you see that?" "See what?" He goes, that thing. I think it might be a ghost." And they went, "What?" And they all sort of peeked over and someone goes, "Actually, I can see it too. Me too." And as they watch, this ghost gets closer and closer and closer. When all of a sudden Peter goes, "Wait, I don't think that's a ghost. I think that's Jesus." And you know, next thing that Peter did, I think, is one of the bravest things that someone in the Bible did. He stands up and goes, "Jesus, if it's you, tell me to come and walk on the water to you." And you know what? Jesus said, "Okay, Peter, come." And Peter went and hopped out of the boat and looking at Jesus, he started to walk on the water. And as he was walking towards Jesus, all of a sudden, he got distracted. I don't know, maybe some water splashed in his face or there was a big crack of lightning. Whatever it was, he got distracted. And as he stood there, he suddenly looked around and he could see the big waves and he could hear the noise and he was seeing lightning and hearing the thunder rumble. And do you know what happened? Peter started to sink. And as he was sinking, he suddenly yelled out, "Jesus! Save me!" And you know what? Jesus reached down and pulled him up. They went back. He took him back to the boat and Jesus said to the storm to still. And the storm did. You know, there are lots of things that sometimes we don't understand. But you know who does? God. And when things are beyond our understanding, the person we can turn to help us understand is Jesus. Pastor Caitlin's going to be talking to us more about that in a moment. But I hope you have a wonderful week this next week, and I will see you next time. See ya!
Hi, Connect Kids. Today we are talking about trusting in God. Can I tell you a little story? When I was a young teenager, I felt God speak to me through the Bible for the first time, and I have never forgotten that moment. Do you know, I was asked to share about my favorite verse in the Bible with a Connect group, and I went home and I was like, I don't know what I have to share. But God spoke to me about a verse in the Bible, and it was from Proverbs 3, verse 5 to 6, and it says, "Trust in the Lord with all of your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. Acknowledge the Lord in all of your ways, and he will make your path straight." What an amazing verse. And I have never forgotten it. It talks about trusting in the Lord and he will show you what path to take. He will direct your steps. So we're going to talk a little bit more about that today. Our first point is I can always trust God. Do you know God created you? He knew exactly what you're going to look like. He knew exactly what your passions and interests were going to be. He knows everything about you. It says that your days are written in his book. Before you were even born, he knew the days of your life and he had a plan for you. So because of that, we can trust him. We can trust him to look after us. We can trust him to lead us and help us walk down the right path in life. Our second point is I must trust him with all my heart. You know what? Sometimes it's easy to say that I will trust God with my all, But when reality hits, that is actually harder to do. The way we mostly live is we trust Him with most of our heart. We still like to be in control of our lives and make a lot of decisions. And you know what? God has given us free will to make choices. But sometimes we don't include God in our choices as much as we could. We don't trust Him as much as we could, maybe. So we encourage you today to trust Him with all your heart. Sometimes we don't understand the big picture. We don't understand everything. But that's why I love this verse. It says to trust in the Lord even when we don't understand. He understands way more than we do, and He can see the big picture. Remember, He's seen all your days already. So our challenge is just to trust Him no matter what, with all our hearts, with all our mind, with all our will, and He will direct our paths. So the important thing to remember today is to trust God with all of our hearts, and He will help us make the right decisions, and He will guide us down the right path in life. See you next time.
Wow, that was such a good lesson.
Well, remember, Connect Kids, to be kind.
The Lord is with you, and wash your hands.
Bye.